Unfortunately, this is a lot of similarities to 1918. Like influenza, this is a respiratory virus that's easily spread. 1918, we had virus jump from animals to people, spread around the world, infected roughly a third of the world's population. This hasn't threatened anything like that. There are two basic lessons from 1918. The first involves social distancing, school closings, you know, closing bars, restaurants, all the obvious things that are being done now. If we are going to be successful, we have to get widespread compliance. That is up to all of us. They managed to do it in South Korea. They managed to do it in Singapore. They managed to do it in Hong Kong. They've done remarkable things over there. Part of that is an issue of testing. We're obviously still way behind the curve. I think we will be in a race whether we get enough tests out there soon enough to be able to suppress the virus, or whether by that time it'll be so widespread there'll be no point. Maybe the most important number coming out of China was that the case fatality rate in Wuhan was 5.8%. Case fatality rate in the rest of China was 0.7%. And the difference, the eightfold difference, that's because in Wuhan, the healthcare system all but collapsed. If you have your resources, if you have your ventilators, you can do much, much better.